Are you looking to ramp things up inside of Smart Suite? Maybe you need to create a document based on some information that already exists inside of your applications. Well, in this video, I'm going to be doing this very thing, showing you how you can design an invoice, including line item support, using the Document Designer feature inside of Smart Suite. So if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I own Gap Consulting, and we make it our mission to help you get organized and automated with no-code tools. Smart Suite is one of our favorite tools heading into the new year here, and we are really excited about this new feature that is coming out, the Document Designer. Now, before we get into it, I have to warn you that I have alpha access to this. It is not yet even in beta testing. So this is really preliminary. It's not yet made public for anyone else inside of Smart Suite. So please note that depending on when you watch this video, you might not be able to access this feature just yet. But I'm excited to share it with you because it is groundbreaking and it is on the precipice of being released. Now, that being said, there are also some advanced features that aren't quite yet ready that I'm gonna have to talk to that I can't actually share because of the fact that it's in alpha. So that's the first takeaway. Now, before we get into the heart of the video, I wanna invite you to check out some free training. I have an automation training that's gonna help you leverage the power of no code once you understand the key fundamentals of no code automation. So check out that training, get it sent directly to you by signing up at garethpronovost.com/webinar-registration. I'm not exaggerating when I say that you can start automating 10 to 20 hours worth of your time every week just by understanding how these tools really work. So grab that training at your convenience. And also, I invite you to follow us along inside of Smart Suite. If you don't already have a Smart Suite account, check out our affiliate link below. If you choose to upgrade to a paid plan on Smart Suite, you will then get some sick Smart Suite swag if you go ahead and apply through our link. Now that we've got the housekeeping out of the way, let's hop on into the heart of the video and take a look at my structure for creating an invoice. So before we ever get to anything more advanced, automations or using document designers or any of these fancy add-ons, we always have to make sure that we have the proper structure in place. So what we're dealing with here is the following applications. Now, I want to point out that you could put these in separate solutions, but for the sake of our example today, I'm keeping all four of these apps in the same place so that we can just flip between them. So the first one here is going to be our contacts application. This should come as no surprise, but every time we write an invoice, we're going to send that invoice to somebody. So we're going to save that information, the contact information, in its own unique application. Because if you recall, an application is really just a set of data that has its own specific similarities. So in the case of contacts, for our example, I'm including a full name field. I'm including a company name if they want to tell us what company they're purchasing on behalf of. And I'm also bringing in some additional information. So here I've just included some sample data inside of a long text field. 123 Main Street, Nowhereville, Utah, 90210. And oftentimes, especially if you're working in the UK, there are some additional requirements when creating and producing invoices in terms of including different tax identification that we don't require in the US. So depending on where you're doing business, you might choose to include some additional information as well. And for this, I've just produced a fake VAT number, but you get the idea. You can include extra data here so that you can put together the invoice that your clients need. So that's the first part, contacts. Now let's switch over to inventory, our second table. Now this, of course, presupposes that we are offering some tangible goods. So maybe you have services that you would use in place of inventory, or maybe you do in fact sell actual goods, in which case you might have an inventory table. So here I'm imagining that we are a hockey pro shop, so we sell different things like pants, sticks, tape, pads, etc. So here we're tracking our cost per unit, and this we don't have to worry about in terms of creating our invoice, but what we do care about is the price per unit. What are we selling this thing for? Now, from there, we're gonna move on to the line items. So when somebody buys something, ideally they're purchasing more than one thing at a time. So on the invoice, we're gonna break down line item support for them, and this needs to live in its own application. So here inside of line items, I have the following different line items for my example. So in this case, we had somebody who purchased hockey pants, elbow pads, hockey shoulders, hockey sticks, and hockey skates. Now here we also note the quantity of things purchased. So in this case, they bought one of everything except for the hockey stick, because who doesn't need an extra twig on the ice? And we are then able to roll up the subtotal. So if we go into this, we can actually look at that dot notation, which takes things an extra level. I really love dot notation formulas because in other software, we would have to first use a lookup field to find the price per unit, then multiply it by the quantity. But you can see here in our formula, we're able to do that all in one step. So I can look at the inventory that I've linked to, find the price of that inventory item, and multiply it by the quantity all in one step. That's what we have here, and so we're now able to get a subtotal for each line item. Now the next step, of course, is to bring back this total of the subtotals, which we see as 975, and put that at the invoice level, so let's get to work. We have our final application here, which we've called invoice, and here we have the invoice number automatically generated. We're using the auto number here, and we are using a formula to add 1,000 to the auto number. So as we create every new record, it's gonna tick up to the next auto number in the sequence, and we're just gonna add that number to 1,000 and automatically produce our invoice number. Now moving on from here, we also have the contact, so we've linked to the contact application, and of course we've linked to the line items application as well, so you'll see here all the different line items for this particular invoice. Now the magic happens at the invoice total, and as you would expect, we've written a nice formula that's gonna look at all the links that we have to line items and bring back the subtotal. So before we get to our document designer, let's first put together another sample invoice. We would just create a new item here. We see that the invoice number fills out automatically, and we would go ahead and add our contact. So who is it? And I only have the one contact in our contact app. And now we need to worry about the line items. What did this person purchase? We can go over to line items and set this all up. So we would add a record. I've grouped by this record, so I'll actually delete this and now link it to the new invoice that I've just created. And so we would just say, well, what did they buy? Maybe they came in and got some new skates and that was it. They just purchased one thing of skates. And so we give Smart Suite a moment to catch up and it says, okay, cool. I know what the subtotal is, $350. Let's move back to the invoice now, and we see that we've linked to that one item, and we have the total here. So on our invoice now, we want to create that PDF or that invoice output automatically through the document designer. So in order to do this, we need to now set up that document designer at the application level. So for us, we're building an invoice document designer. So we go to our invoice application, click on the application arrow, and if we scroll on down, we already see that we have a default created here. I put this together really as a test, and so what we want to do for the sake of this example is to create a new design. We could choose to rename our document if we wanted right here. I'll go ahead and skip that. We know that we have this particular document that we're creating. What I first want to draw your attention to are the different elements that we can access to enhance our document. So on the left-hand side of our screen, we have the elements here that include line, rectangle, circle, or text. So we can add these different variables, if you will, to our design and enhance it the way we would like. We also can come down to fields here. And on fields, we have access to all of the fields that live in the application that we built this document inside. In our case, we did that in the invoice application. So these are all the different fields that live there. You'll see things that look familiar, like the invoice number, also the link back to line items, etc. Now, from there, we can also look down to settings, and settings allow us to determine how we want to display this information. Is this going to be on letter 8.5 by 11, or do you have a different dimension for this particular design? And also, is it portrait or landscape mode, up and down or side to side? In our case, I'll go ahead and pick 8.5 by 11, and I'll make sure that we remain in portrait mode. So let's now flip back to the fields. The number one thing we want here is line item detail for our invoice. So you'll notice that we actually don't have the accessibility to bring in our invoice total. And so this is a little bit surprising, but don't fear, we can still get the output we're looking for. Let's start by bringing in the link to line items. We need that line by line breakdown. Now by default, if we click on this element that we just added, we're gonna see two pieces were included here. This is the title from each of those linked records, as well as the description from each of those linked records. Well, I never even filled out the description. There's no information there, so I'm gonna toss that entirely. but I do have the ability to access an additional thing. I can bring in extra information. So in our case, I really care about the subtotal. We have to show what the line item detail for that particular item was. So I can bring in subtotal, and there we go, we have that. Now the title of these elements, these line items, includes the invoice number plus the item, and that's a little bit difficult to understand. So let me make a change here. Instead, I'll come in and say, actually, I want to bring in the actual inventory name. So I don't want to know the title here. I can ditch title altogether. Now you'll notice that I don't have the ability yet of reorganizing these things. To have the subtotal come before the inventory looks a little funny. So I'm going to ditch the inventory, ditch the subtotal, and start again. Let me put them in the order that I want them in. I'm going to bring in the inventory, and now I will add the subtotal. Let's find it again. And now we should be in the right order. Things are looking pretty good. Now, one other thing that I might want here is to bring in the cost per unit. If you recall, we didn't have cost per unit in our table because we used the formula that automatically takes the cost per unit and multiplies it by the quantity sold. So this is extra information we probably would want on a line item. So let's go ahead and pause here. I'll save the design, and we're going to go back into our line items and actually add this information. I'm going to go ahead and add a new field, and it's going to be a lookup field. I'm going to look up the information that is the price per unit. So I'll look at the inventory that we've linked to and find the price per unit in the list here of elements, and I'm going to bring that in for this field. I'll rename this lookup to be price per unit. And this is going to help us now on our itemization for our inventory. So I'll bring this price per unit. In fact, I'll reorganize it so that it's on the left-hand side of the subtotal. And now let's get back into our designer. Now that I'm back inside of my document designer, I can go back to this element. Again, let's mess around with that ordering. I'll pull out the subtotal and I will come in and bring in the price per unit, which I've now added right here. I'll bring in the quantity so that we can provide a better analysis of what was purchased and how many of each, and then we'll include that subtotal after that. So now I have a nice line by line here. This is what you bought, this is how much each one was, how many you got of that, and here's your subtotal. So this is pretty good. Also note that your position can be set to relative. Now this is groundbreaking because relative positioning means that depending on how long the list is, it will extend automatically here. So as the list gets longer, it will know that you want it to be set to a relative size, and it will resize that based on the number of line item elements that you've added in this particular link. So this is a really powerful feature that is going to take your document designs to the next level. So be sure to include the relative toggle here in any case where you're not exactly sure how many things might exist in any particular scenario. In our example for line items, we don't know how many line items we're gonna have, so we better bring it in right here. Now we can go ahead and resize this if we wanna grow it, make it any larger, and drop it in wherever we need to. Now what you'll notice is that I have my line item information included, but I don't yet have the other information I require for this particular element. So I would definitely need to bring in some extra stuff like my invoice number itself. Let's bring that in right here. And of course, we can resize it by coming into the font size. Let's say this is 25 size font. We want to make it much larger. And we can play with the alignment of this element. So if we want it left, center, or right justification, again, use that relative position if you think that this might get longer. And we can also change the color of the text. We have all of these possibilities from just the drop-down selection, or we can come in with some custom colors by dropping in a hex code here and picking the precise color that we want for this particular element. I'll keep it with black for now, but I want you to understand the large number of options for you when designing your different documents. So from here, we might be happy with the invoice number. We can bring in additional information, like the contact information as well. So here I have the contact information. I can remove the title. I can remove the description. Maybe all I care about in this case is the name of the person, so I can bring in the full name. I can also include those additional elements like the VAT number, the address, and the company as needed if I so choose. Now, other elements that we would want to bring in would be things like the date of the invoice creation, the due date. I didn't add those elements to our example, but you can definitely include them in yours as well so that your invoice has all the information you require. Now from there, the last piece we would need is the total of this invoice, the ability to bring in this number here, the sum of all these subtotals, and you'll notice that on our example, we can't actually bring in that formula that we have that's properly calculating that number right now. Unfortunately, this is just the reality when looking at things that are in alpha testing. Everything doesn't work all the time, but I want to bring your attention to this other document that was already created in this sandbox. And you'll notice that there are elements here. In this case, this is our sales tax formula. So we have used a formula inside of these examples in the past. And so while SmartSuite is continuing to work on perfecting this element, there's going to be some time where we can't access all the things. But by the time it's released to the public, I'm sure that the vast majority of these glitches will be taken care of. So do know that when the time comes, you'll be able to bring in those formulas and add them to your different templates so that you can automatically create the document that you're looking for. Now, as a closing thought for this document, what are you going to do with it once you've created your template? Well, the nice thing is we can now cycle through all of our different records and we can see those invoices. And obviously the data on our screen is updated based on the invoice that we're looking at that time. At present, what we can do is either export this data and it automatically creates a PDF that we can open up and we then see that version right here. Alternatively, we can print this. So we can go to our printer, select whatever we want to print, and go ahead and put that up on our 8.5 by 11 or whatever size paper you were using for your example. Now, while we don't have this functionality yet, at least in the alpha testing mode, we will soon get from SmartSuite the capability of creating these documents automatically. So the ability to utilize this document designer template that we've put together and leverage that with the power of SmartSuite automations so that when certain conditions are met, then our document is automatically created and stored back inside of our database. That will be the holy grail of SmartSuite PDF generation. So imagine in the future that we have the capability of just adding an attachment field here where we collect our files and images, and we can just call this invoice, and we can establish that when we push a button inside of our application, then that will automatically create an invoice and upload it right here, as well as share that invoice via email with our clients. Lots of potential here, and I am really excited to see where this is headed over the next few months as SmartSuite continues to work very vigorously at perfecting this new feature. Let me know in the comments below which of these features you are most looking forward to. And if you haven't already subscribed to this channel, but you want to stay up on top of no-code news like this, be sure to hit that subscribe button, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. As always, I hope you found this to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website to see how we can help. We offer an exclusive free training that teaches the fundamentals of no-code tools, including automation. We also have some paid services available, including advanced courses, no-code hourly consulting, as well as custom project consulting. So swing on by to get the help you need, and we look forward to connecting with you soon.